Hello! Over the many years I've been making these videos, I have shown all sorts of different canal boats. Narrow boats, long ones, short ones, traditional, modern, old and new. I've shown wide beam narrow boats and of course fiberglass cabin cruisers. But there's one type of canal and river boat that, although I've been past them and pointed them out, I've never actually had a good old nose round. So the time has come to rectify that by going round this Dutch barge.
This is Bulbury. 60 feet long, 12 feet 6 inches wide and constructed in steel, it was built in 2007 by Blue Water Boats, and it's on the market.
Just to be clear about one thing, the boat is for sale, but this is not an advert. In other words, I have not been paid in any form whatsoever to make this video. In fact, I saw the boat for sale and thought, that looks interesting, I'd like to go and look around that, and I asked them if I could come and make it. Now, if you happen to have the £235,000 asking price and you're interested, I'll leave a link in the video description below. But this is all being done of my own volition. With that out of the way, let's have a look round.
There's a very distinctive style to a Dutch barge, starting with the bow, which tends to swoop upwards to a point with a straight, almost vertical stem. Solid cleats secure the hefty hull to any mooring. On this design, a hatch enables access to the anchor locker. The cabin roof has a gentle slope with grab rails running along its length for holding onto as you walk along the gunwales. A large skylight lets sunshine into the living area below. Porthole windows give more privacy in the bathroom with larger bus-style double-glazed glass in the saloon. A raised but collapsible wheelhouse is traditional on this kind of boat, about a third of the way along from the back. It makes for a glorious place to lounge in the sunshine, as well as somewhere to steer. Finally, at the rear is the main cabin, portholes again for privacy. The curvaceous rear end houses the mechanics for the rudder and prop shaft. Let's step aboard and ask the current owners how they came to buy it.
We felt we wanted a complete change in our life, so we decided to go for a Dutch barge. We were looking for a smaller house and not being very interested. So we thought, well, we'll just go for it. And we enjoyed the process of having it built. And it was a nice positive thing to do.
When we had the narrowboat, which was for recreational purposes, from time to time, it's only occasional, we saw upon the system on our travels, the occasional Dutch barge. And it was one of those desires in life. You like the look of it and lust over one. But it was fantasy time. It was never going to happen. And I was the stick in the mud. Wherever we went to find a smaller house, that's something I was moaning about or complaining about. And my wife came up with the idea, well, if we have something smaller, why don't we have one of those Dutch barges we thought we were never going to have? And it was an instant decision. So we put the house for sale, found a boat builder, sold the narrowboat, and financial times are better than they are now. And here we are, 16 years later.
Inside the wheelhouse, you get the sense of this being a little ship rather than just a canal or riverboat. Controls include a bow thruster, there are four bilge pumps, plus the usual gauges to monitor the engine. The view ahead is commanding and yet doesn't feel overwhelming, though a third of the boat's length is behind you, which you'll have to bear in mind when manoeuvring.
It gives people the impression when they see us up and down the waterways that it's like a ship. And it's because of the design. The fact is, it's 60 feet long, 12 and a half feet wide, and it has the same footprint as the wide beam boat in front of us now, or many others that you see on the system. It just happens to look a lot bigger. I don't know what the technical term would be, but no, it's very easy to manage.
At the back of the wheelhouse is a comfortable seating area with table, perfect for reading the paper with a cup of tea and a pastry on a sunny morning. The boat is rated as Type D, which means estuary cruising is very feasible.
Oh, well, we love going to Bristol because that's where our son lives and we've got grandchildren there. And you might think that's a strange place to go for a holiday. But it's a lovely journey there by boat. We go down from Sharpness to Portishead on the estuary, Severn Estuary, and we always take a pilot with us so that we're not nervous in any way, you know, we take their advice. And then there's lots going on in Portishead, which we stay overnight there, at least one night. But then we go up the Avon and stop off at Bristol, and we might spend a week there. And there's lots to do with the grandchildren, and it's thoroughly enjoyable.
Entering the main accommodation is done via this hatch and doorway to the side. The steps take you into a light, inviting living space. The kitchen, or galley, sits against the wheelhouse wall and is just as full-featured as you'd find in any house. There are cupboards with worktop to the side and additional storage under the steps. Under gunwale cupboards are a nice use of space. Looking forward is the cosy combined dining and living area. The foldable dining table can pull out to seat six if needed. And you're kept warm not only by the wood burner, but centrally heated radiators. This particular mooring has a glorious view of a lock, so you get to gongoozle as you sit. There's loads of light from the skylight, and the panes can be opened to let heat out in summer. A sofa bed provides night accommodation for guests, but otherwise this is the main living area, and there's that wood-burning stove.
We keep speculating who might want to buy it. Does someone want to buy it as the equivalent of a second home, a bolt hole? Does someone want to do what we did, and buy it and have a nice place to live? I mean, you couldn't afford a place like this on the Thames, a house, river, even up in the village in Wyre. One of the houses up there with a garden down to the river, you know, we're talking about £400,000, £500,000 at least for property. You don't have to spend that much here to have a river presence. So anyone who wants that, otherwise I find it difficult to explain. Boating for some people is, they never take them out. There's no point in having a boat if you don't take it out. So it could be a serious boater, because it's more like an activity holiday. You're not lying on a beach waiting for the sun to come out or go in. There's always something to do. Managing locks, managing the boat, checking this, checking that. It's just interesting. Trying to work out the weather when one's going down the Severn Estuary and back across the estuary to get up to Bristol. Your mind is always occupied with what if, what must we do, what are the tides going to be like, which is the wind direction, etc, etc.
We think it might go to Europe, because there are lots of people there on Dutch barges in France and Holland. So we think somebody might buy it and take it over there.
From the front corner of the lounge, where the TV and stereo sit, there's a corridor to the bow, which ingeniously houses an office area with space for laptop, printer and paraphernalia. Opposite that is the main bathroom, which houses a large shower, toilet plumbed to a holding tank and a wash basin, as well as suitable space for towels and such like. There's also an access hatch in the floor for some of the plumbing. Finally, if you walk to the end of the workspace, the corridor goes across the width of the boat to provide, at the bow bulkhead, a coats and storage area, which usefully has a radiator down below to ensure wet clothes can easily be dried. There's also yet more cupboard space and access to the locker at the bow. Here's a look back at the saloon from the office. But wait, what's that doorway at the back of the galley? We haven't explored that yet. This is a bit of genius. On most similar boats, you have to go up into the wheelhouse and over to get to the back room. Not this one, where you go down, which also gives direct access to the engine room instead of having to lever up floorboards. And what an engine room it is! Plenty of space, even headroom to stand up. There's the Vitus DT44 diesel engine with 114 horsepower and a ZF gearbox. Look how clean that is. Those are hydraulics for the gearbox and other mechanical elements. There's also a diesel heater in here for the radiators and hot water system. Not to mention storage for engine consumables. And a Vitus 6.5 kVA generator too. Back out in that corridor is space for a washing machine, as well as the electric switch panel and a freezer. Finally then, at the rear is the master cabin, a spacious room with a double bed and the pretty porthole windows we saw from the outside. You'll notice seemingly no radiator heating the room at the side. That's deliberate, to leave more space for accessible storage. But there are radiators here, under the sides of the bed, using otherwise awkward space. The headboard comes away to give you access to the rudder, stern greaser and bilge pump if you need it. Also, cleverly, it forms part of a fire escape system, whereby you can step onto the bedside table, then up onto the back of the headboard, and then out from the overhead hatch. These doors appear to be cupboards, and for the two at the end, that's true, but the third hides an ensuite toilet. Just a toilet, no shower, but it saves you having to step past any guests on the sofa bed if you need a wee in the middle of the night. This is not a cheap boat by any stretch of the imagination, and you will find others listed for less, but the owners say you've got to do a like-for-like comparison.
If you can't afford that price, then of course it's too much money, never mind a lot of money, it's too much money. Some people might think, well, I've seen Dutch barges for sale at tens of thousands of pounds cheaper. But are they comparing like with like? This was a solidly well-built boat. It had lots of extras that other boats might not have done. If people can afford a price close to ours, come and make comparisons with what might appear to be a similar thing but much cheaper. Just come and have a look and see what you're comparing it with. Have a look and see what you're getting for your money.